I am Fabio, and I am ready for MKidz. Are you ready? When I say MKidz, you say yeah. MKidz, yeah. MKidz, yeah. MKidz, yeah. Let's begin.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Shine. On a Monday, I'm gonna let it shine. On a Tuesday, I'm gonna let it shine. On a Wednesday, I'm gonna let it shine. On a Thursday, oh yeah. On a Friday, I'm gonna let it shine. On a Saturday, I'm gonna let it shine. On a Sunday morning, praise the Lord, I'm gonna let my little light shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Shine. On a Tuesday, I'm gonna let it shine. On a Wednesday, I'm gonna let it shine. On a Thursday, oh yeah. On a Friday, I'm gonna let it shine. On a Saturday, I'm gonna let it shine. On a Sunday morning, praise the Lord, I'm gonna let my little light, let my little light, let my little light shine.
Hello, I'm Jasper. Thanks for having me here at MKidz today. I want to ask you something. Come closer, please. Can you hear me? Okay, I think I'm going to whisper this. I feel a bit silly. Here goes. Do you ever feel like everyone else is better than you? Like maybe you say, look, I got a new toy. And then your friends say, oh, that's nice, I've got a bigger one. Or you say, my dad is taking me camping. And then your friends say, my dad is taking me to Cape Town on a plane. Or maybe you've even thought that you're really fast runner or good at something just to find out someone else is better. The worst is when you get pushed aside because of it. Like maybe your friend says you're not his best friend anymore because he's found a nicer one. Or you can't play with them anymore because you're not good enough at something. Have you ever felt that way? I feel like that sometimes. I wonder if God will still want me to be a hero for him. I don't always feel special or important enough.
Hey, Jasper, my friend. It's so nice to have you here at MKidz. I couldn't help overhearing. I'm so sorry you feel left out and unimportant sometimes. But wow, have I got a story for you.
I'm not sure, Fabio. I'm not really in the mood for a story.
Come
come, lift your chin and take a breath. God has something to help you see that even if people push you aside, you feel left out, he will push you closer and do great things with you. Let's listen to the story of Jephthah.
Today's story we read in Judges 11. Jephthah was a mighty warrior, and his father was Gilead. His mother was a woman who had done really bad things. Gilead's wife also bore him sons, and when they were all grown up, they drove Jephthah away. "You are not going to get any inheritance from our family," they said, "because you are the son of another woman." So Jephthah fled from his brothers and settled in the land of Tob, where a gang of scoundrels gathered around him and followed him. Sometime later, when the Ammonites were fighting against Israel, the elders of Gilead went to get Jephthah from the land of Tob. "Come," they said, "be our commander so that we can fight the Ammonites." Jephthah said to them, "Didn't you hate me and drive me away from my father's house? Why do you come to me now when you're in trouble?" The elders of Gilead said to Jephthah, "Nonetheless, we are turning to you now. Come with us to fight the Ammonites, and you will be head over all of us who live in Gilead." Jephthah answered, "Suppose you take me back to fight the Ammonites, and the Lord gives them to me. Will I really be your head?" The elders of Gilead replied again, "The Lord is our witness. We will certainly do as you say." So Jephthah went with the elders of Gilead, and the people made him head and commander over them. And he repeated all his word before the Lord in Mizpah.
Jephthah's family was not good to him. He didn't have the same mother as his brothers. His parents were not married. His brothers thought they were better than him, and they also said so. They teased him and made sure he knew that they thought he didn't belong. They were really nasty. I think he must have felt terrible. I wonder if he thought, "Nobody wants me. I don't fit in anyway. I'm all alone. Everyone is nasty to me." His family life was difficult. God was with him even when things were at its toughest. God didn't think any less of Jephthah when his life was difficult and his brother said he wasn't good enough. God knew Jephthah was good. He was great. God took his hand and showed him how to be a hero even when people were nasty to him. Jasper, friends, you are good enough. You are great. Even when people are nasty to you, God will show you how to be a hero and do important, wonderful things. Don't believe it when other people tell you are not good enough, or not nice, or not special. When people are nasty to you, take your sadness to Jesus and let him help you feel better again and do wonderful things with him.
Hallo maats, kom ons bid saam.
Jesus,
help ons om te onthou
dat u dink
ons is great.
Selfs al is ander mense
lelik met ons.
Dankie dat u altyd daar is. Dankie dat ons super dinge saam met u kan doen.
Dankie dat ons super dinge met saam u kan doen.
Amen.
Bye bye, maats.